we are all aware of, to call the pet.
Pandit Bhuvanda, the patron of the Arapatini Sabha Fiji, various other spiritual leaders and pundits, Kamlesharia, the acting VC of University of Fiji, and various other dignitaries. Namaste, Bulavinaka, and good evening to all of you. I always feel very Bollywoodish when somebody puts this around me. I don't know what to do with it, whether to throw it over my shoulder or what to do with it, but please bear with me. But I, you know, thank you for the invitation for this evening. A lot obviously has been said in respect of the Shahid Ghat that was built by the Fijian government. This has been a matter that has been pending, you know, in the public space for a couple of decades actually, not more than that. And we know it had been raised in previous parliaments. And when you think about it, I think Pandit Bhuvanda said that one day some of you may go there. Well, actually all of us are going to go somewhere. And those of you who live in Suva invariably will use it, because death is an inevitability. And that's something that we're most sure of. It'll happen to all of us, just as we are born. And so our rationale was that every society, but more so every individual, has the right to depart with dignity. And in particular, if you're fulfilling various rituals, we have to ensure that those rituals are being able to be carried out in a dignified environment, dignified manner, to be able to execute that. We have a program also. Kamal Gaundar was here with us, and you know, I must acknowledge Kamal, who has also been the conduit between the ministry and also the various faith-based organizations. And also Shah, who's not here, who is the head of Construction Implementation Unit. They have a very major hand in respect of ensuring that we were able to put all the facilities together as per the requirements, as per the specifications, so all the rituals could be carried out. And we have a program to try and replicate this in other parts of Fiji. It's not necessarily very inexpensive. There is a cost outlay, but we also have to make sure it's done in a proper manner, that there is proper land tenure, etc. And that we are able to then, you know, pass that facility on to the different faith-based organizations. We did not want to give it to only one organization. That's why we got all the Hindu-based organizations to collectively look after it. You know, when you think about it from one perspective, $50,000 is not that much money on a yearly basis. When you think about the number of people who we know are going to die and use those facilities. So we probably need to inculcate that idea into people's heads. There may be a need to have some form of sustainable funding, and the levy is of course one thing that the organizations requested for, and I'm sure that should be approved very soon. Because it's state land, crown land, it has to go through the lands department, which we are going through that particular process. But I would request the committee to please have it means tested. There are some low-income families that may not be able to afford it. There are some, of course, who can afford it, may be able to, you know, pay a bit more. So if you can cross-subsidize or subsidize those people who are low-income, come from low-income families, at least they have access to it. They don't actually have to fork out money right at the end of somebody's passing away. Just to leave you with those thoughts. And, you know, I think we need to be able to, if we have that common approach of, you know, ensuring that everybody lives with dignity, is born with dignity, departs with dignity, then you will be able to build a better society. And, you know, in that sense of humanity, that sense of human kindness, affection, and love and compassion is very, very important for any country to not just grow, but also to mature and have those, you know, respect for each other's rights and, of course, respect for each other's beliefs. So I'd like to thank you for the invitation. This is, of course, unfortunately I cannot stay for too long, but I normally like this type of Sangeet nights. And I wish everybody all well, and thank you for those of you who have contributed towards tonight. Naka, thank you.
At the Vatwanga Funeral Rights Committee. Part of Fiji. on the Vatwanga Funeral Rights Committee, but because he was contesting the elections, he opted to log off. When the facility was officially opened, they never missed any days of work since they started work, and it's him and his...
Yani Zabudi कदम बढ़ाने खलों को मिटाने आजा खाली पन में भी कर देना तेरे बिन खानी आजा खाली पन में तेरे बिन खानी आजा खाली पन में
मुझसे ही
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.